Hello and welcome to another episode of Eliphas Leary's Lectures About Magic. In this episode I want to talk a little bit about curses. Basically, there are two different kinds of curses. First of all, curses through spirits, or that come from spirits, and curses that come from other human beings. The curses from spirits are not too dangerous, not something you should worry about. Most of the time they are the result of something that you did wrong. For example, you've been to some sacred place, to some holy place, lake, forest, something like that, and you behaved in a not appropriate way. For example, you threw some garbage into the environment. Now, the way to get rid of that curse is get back to that place, take your garbage and get rid of it in the usual way, throw it in the dustbin. Curses from spirits are almost all the time something that should make you learn. You have to come to some kind of realization where you behaved wrong. Spirits from other persons are something completely different, because sometimes they just work their curses out of a bad mood. Sometimes in different forums on the internet I find people asking stuff like, I don't know if I have been cursed, but my life's a mess at the moment, and stuff like that. And my answer to that is always, there is no curse. No person has cursed you. Maybe you did something wrong in some place, but you definitely have not been cursed by a person. Because curses from persons need something like a notification. In voodoo they use little fetishes, little things made out of some bones and some colorful ribbons and feathers and stuff like that. And the Hungans put those somewhere where the cursed person has to find it, so that the cursed person knows it has been cursed. Something like a notification is necessary to make the curse working, to make the curse work. And the curse is only working when the cursed person thinks of the person working the curse like some authority figure. You can't work a curse when you don't have authority, or when the cursed person doesn't think that you have authority. At least the authority to work a curse, to have that kind of influence on their lives. That doesn't always take some kind of fetish. Sometimes an evil gazing is everything it takes. But as in the case with the spirit that curses you, it takes a little more than just authority. There's also some feeling of guilt that is necessary to make a curse work. For example, someone bullying someone else around, and the person that has been bullied gazing in a evil way at the bully. The bully feels kind of sick. It's his own bad feeling about what he has done that makes him feel bad, that makes him feel sick. And there we have the best way to get rid of a curse. It's denying the cursing person the authority. I know two cases where people have been cursed by lodges, by orders or brotherhoods. In the one case, the cursed person didn't think of that lodge as a conglomerate of authority figures. It was quite the opposite, that's why he left the lodge. And in the other case, the cursed person knew that she was doing that she has done lots of bad stuff, and so in the first case the curse was not effective, in the second case it was very effective. Well, I hope these explanations did help you in some way, or did bring you to some new insights or some inspiration. Not inspiration to curse, I hope. Personally, I don't like to work with curses. I think that's most of the time not necessary and just a waste of time. There are better ways to solve problems. Well, as I said, I hope this was some kind of useful to you. Enjoy your life, enjoy the summer and every other season. See you soon.